Vaguely Dangerous Wilderness is a groundbreaking tramping comedy documentary web series. In this special episode, interviews with the cast and crew take us vaguely behind the scenes for a unique glimpse at the making of Vaguely Dangerous Wilderness.
Yep.
It's going.
So, we are the Tramping for Recreation Club.
And also the very super famous media company.
Welcome to Vaguely Dangerous Wilderness Behind the Scenes.
Yeah, so Vaguely Dangerous Wilderness started back in 2013, I think it was, when I brought along my new camera to a tramp we were doing to Cow Creek and Mitre Flats. And I had this idea of testing out the video function of the camera by filming like this kind of piss take video of man versus wild and, you know, like nature documentaries and that kind of thing. I'm also inspired by the fact that the forecast was absolutely terrible for that weekend, and our parents kept telling us, you know, oh, the rivers could be swollen, it'll be raining heaps, it could be dangerous, you haven't been tramping for a while, you might die, and that kind of thing. And it just kind of snowballed from there. And to be honest, it was pretty terrible.
Being washed away, God!
I mean, it was funny, but it was funny because it was terrible. I mean, it just failed on so many levels. It's been a rocky road since then. Every episode has improved in at least one or two aspects, but they also, in a strange way, seem to go backwards in other aspects. I mean, in episode 3 we didn't even attempt any humour at all.
Like, almost no planning goes into these things. Like, we just kind of have ideas and stuff, but it's mostly pretty improvised. We're pretty good at improvising though, so usually comes out okay.
We're pretty shit at improvising, in all honesty. We try doing planning, but can never be bothered doing any actual scripting, and we kind of plan things on our own, and, you know, once we're then out in the bush, everything just kind of goes out the metaphoric window.
Yeah, like, we were supposed to film a bunch of stuff on our last tramp of us, like, talking about behind-the-scenes stuff, but, you know, as usual, it just kind of fell apart. Like, half the time, we just kind of give up with filming and just chuck the camera on logs and walk past the camera. And there was that time it was, like, just happened to be pointing up, and there was this really cool sun flare.
If you're lost and alone, or you're sinking like a stone, carry on.
It was super cool. But yeah, usually it's a bit shaky with our filming, because cameras are hard to hold still. It's a bit chaotic at times. Especially with that time when the camera broke from the rain.
Yeah, filming in the bush can be pretty challenging. Like, there's all sorts of crap we have to deal with. Like, the fact we have to carry all our gear means can't bring heavy shit like a tripod. Plus there's the weather that we have to deal with.
On that roaring stag tramp, when it got so wet that it stopped working, and the next day we refilmed things. But you can tell because my pants are different colour in some of the scenes. Then they change back again, like 2 seconds later.
Yeah.
It kind of worked though. Like, I don't know, it's just more random, like our stuff normally is. Organic or maybe natural. That sounds pretty accurate.
Nice.
I thought that.
Pretty soon, when the downhill starts getting steeper, we're going to have to be careful that we don't fall over because, you know, we're carrying expensive equipment and the last thing we want is to fall over and damage these. Like, limbs can be repaired. And, like, if we break our leg, we can just keep going. It's not an issue. But if we break the camera, I mean, this whole episode is fucked, really, isn't it? Gotta be careful.
I think the soundtrack is a very important part of Vaguely Dangerous. Super. A lot of work goes into putting that together. I was spent trying to find just the right music for the moment, like the Proclaimers song in the first episode, which was freaking awesome. Kind of felt like we were walking for thousands of miles, so it was pretty perfect. And, you know, it was all upbeat, which kind of matched our upbeat tone at the time. But it didn't last for very long. It was pretty much gone by the second day.
So pretty much for the music, I just picked something out from my iTunes library that won't sound too out of place. I've also got some soundtrack music from films and TV that I use sometimes as well, just as long as it sounds good, you know.
The soundtrack's getting better, I think. Like, I try to find stuff that kind of fits now rather than just chucking in any random song, like the first cut of episode 3. God, that was weird. That was just a random collection of music from my iTunes library.
It's just kind of...
I mean, they were good songs, but it made absolutely no sense.
The Queen songs on the credits, just fantastic, though.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they pull it all together, really. I mean, like, you can have orchestral music, maybe, like, weird synthy 80s stuff that I may or may not have stolen from Miami Vice. But then it just all gets pulled together by this fantastic Queen track at the end.
Queen brings everyone together.
It does. We should go and listen to some Queen. Nice.
Nifty.
There was this one time recently that we tried making our own soundtrack. Watched it too. Yeah, there are no words.
I'm super happy to eat this squished sandwich.
It looks terrible, but it's hard to express just how happy I am to be able to stop and eat some food.
Braden's nearby. I don't know, a little bit behind me. And I'm currently looking at a super nice view. It is super windy. Still good view. So we estimate about two, maybe three more hours before we get to the hut. Hopefully not three though. And this is how much water I've got. And same with Braden.
I've just been down to the river to fill up my bottle before we leave. And that music's really distracting.
So sure. Restart.
If a tree falls in the forest and no one's around to hear it except for one man, but the tree falls on that man and kills him, does the man dying make a sound?
Yeah, so as we say in the videos, the wilderness can be pretty vaguely dangerous at times. Like, there's all sorts of risks, like hypothermia and shit. But on the whole, for us, it's like falling over and getting lost.
Son of a bastard!
Yeah, there's a lot of opportunities to trip up. Like, a lot of people don't realize, but tramping tracks aren't actually paved. It's just like some dirt and there's rocks and like roots and shit, and you know, plus nature can be pretty gross.
Sometimes like bugs and stuff. Track's actually a stream because it's merged with a stream, and the stream's just like and follows the track.
The long drops can be pretty terrifying sometimes.
That one in the middle of the spider one.
Sometimes I think that we need to do more planning for Vaguely Dangerous Wilderness, do more scripting, have a more cohesive cohesiveness between every episode. But in many ways I think the randomness and inconsistencies is kind of a good thing. And what you get is every episode has its own unique thing and stuff, and I forget where I'm going with this. Me and Cody, Cody and I, sometimes, you know, we go through these kind of phases of being into a certain thing or saying certain phrases or whatever for a few months. Doge was one of them, the meme. Also pronounced Doge. Then there was the weird gangster / Rhys Darby voice that you can see in episode 3. And we don't really think about it at the time, but then I watch these episodes back. Kind of Vaguely Dangerous Wilderness was, as far as I'm aware, the first tramping comedy documentary. And to this day, as far as I know, is the only tramping comedy documentary, and is the leading tramping comedy documentary on YouTube. One of our videos has, I think, 42 views. That's episode 3, I think. Episode 5, which came out a couple of weeks ago, already has over 10. And episode 2 has one comment on it. Someone commented.
3 years.
It's not that bad, I suppose. Man, I don't know how I drank this all the time, though. Probably because it was $11.
That was all. That's pretty much it, really. Don't forget to watch our videos or we'll chop your toes off. Thanks for watching. Bye now.
Dad. I'm Cody's brother and that other random person who commented on one of the videos that one time. Bye. Has it stopped yet? Does it? We really need to get a cameraman.